There are a lot fewer two-parent families.
What's worth more, a dollar today or a dollar tomorrow?
Almost nobody gets out of love alive.
Prisoners' rights is out of sight, out of mind.
Is your brain on fire?
Hello?
Yeah, you know what though? And this is what I thought about when you was asking about that you have to be a certain kind of way. Because I always kind of felt like it depends. You know, I always go back to the teacher. Whenever somebody always gets passionate about something, passionate about they feel like any kind of specialist, it's usually because they had a teacher or somebody, a mentor or somebody that inspires them.
Right.
Right. There's information inspiring. I mean, I don't think there's enough of them. But it also made me think how tricky that shit is. Like you know, earlier this week, and I actually even had to do with that. The one I told you came back was like, y'all saw the video on it, and now, you know, got interested in what we're doing.
Right.
And we started talking, because he was talking about how his sister, which is Jehovah's Witness, it was like having a conversation for like a couple of hours, and then she started mentioning the Bible. And started mentioning all this other stuff. And he was like, oh, why are you bringing that into it? And she started breaking it down. He's like, oh, you really believe all of that? You know what I mean? And he's like, all right, so tell me the story that you believe in. And, you know, he started talking about knowing. He started breaking down, you know, the whole story of Noah. But it made me think, because the day before that, there was this chick that I worked with. I never talked to her before. This is the first day we've been in the area together. So me and her started talking. And she's young. She's 24. She's from New York. So I asked her, you know, what brought you down to Georgia? And she was like, you know, I just recently got saved, you know, about a year ago, and you know, I'm pretty much following you know, my calling, you know, whatever it is. And you know, me and talking, and then she asked if I was a Christian, and I said no.
Right.
And then, you know, later on in the conversation, she asked me why am I not a Christian. And I kind of felt weird for the fact that she's young, she recently saved, she learning about her life, and something in me was like, yo, I do not want to crush this girl's being. You know what I mean? I don't want to just shit on her way of life, especially if this is something she just found. You know what I mean? Like it felt weird. And I kept on kind of working around the subject. To a point where, honestly, she said, you know, you sound confused. And then I had to really start getting into it more, because, like, no, I'm not confused at all.
Right.
I know my stance. There's very few things that I'm absolute in my way of being. Because I like questioning things. I like, you know, trying to figure things out from different perspectives.
Right.
But this I'm sure of. But then I felt still unsatisfied, because I didn't get into it deeper. First of all, we only had a short time, but I didn't get into it deep as it is. And I'm wondering, when I hear certain things, because it took me a long time to realize certain things. Like how, you know, I've always listened to Boyd Watkins, I've listened to Omar Johnson. There's things I still don't agree with, but one of the things that always kind of, maybe always, in my mind, is why people don't grasp onto them is the way they speak. Because they're very frank, and I think sometimes that might be off-putting to people. So I kind of always kind of registered my way of thinking, because I try to be inclusive, I try to bring people into the conversation. But now I'm starting to wonder if sometimes you just you might need that aggressiveness. You might need that brassness where, you know,
right,
you gotta slap people with information.
Exactly.
And shock them. Because, you know, at times where I realize when I hear certain things that I might have, you know, been feeling it more emotionally than thinking about it intellectually, that when I took the time to actually breathe and think about it, I'm like, you know, it makes sense. It might not make sense in the way that they were saying it to me, that they were interpreting the situation, but I found sense in some of what they're saying, like the way I broke down the information. You know what I mean? Like, when I say with Boyd Watkins, there's one time when he's talking about the white supremacist economy. Right, and if you think about the history of America and what the fortunes of America was built off of, makes more sense. And I think most people might just grasp onto the white supremacist economy. They might just grasp onto that element and bring it to today and not think about all these other aspects. And I started bringing down more information, and I don't know if I'm at a crossroads. my fantasies and certain things, but I just know how I approach it. Like I said, I like y'all to look at information for more
Right.
But I'm realizing sometimes you just gotta be like, no, you're fucking talking about bullshit. Just, hey. You know.